Ed Miliband arrived in Bedford at rush hour and in a hurry to get his message out to as many people as he can before time is up. First stop, a community centre packed with Labour faithful and some undecided voters. First issue, the health service, and a pledge to rescue it from savage Tory cuts.
And it is a plan founded on putting the right values back at the heart of our National Health Service. I think you know what those values are. Care, compassion and cooperation, not privatisation, fragmentation and competition.
This is about the people, he told the audience, showing his charming side as he took questions on public sector pay and social care.
And now, look, I'm not saying this is flattering. You definitely don't look 70. I honestly say that.
But he was less keen to talk on the story that won't go away. Would he still try to be Prime Minister, even if he didn't have the most seats?
I'm not going to start talking about politicians and Friday. I'm going to talk about the British people and what they do on Thursday.
So relaxed and upbeat performance from Ed Miliband, who's leaving to cheers from and selfies with a friendly crowd. But there's no time to relax. He'll be back on the bus and on to the next constituency. The pace is picking up.
So he didn't need a last-minute gaffe over this stone tablet. It was unveiled at the weekend with Labour's key pledges chiselled in. The idea, the promises can't disappear. Already mocked by his political rivals, this morning one of his own campaign chiefs seemed to doubt it was a rock-solid idea.
I don't think anyone's suggesting that the fact he's carved them stone means, you know, he's absolutely, you know, not going to break them or anything like that.
As the campaign continued, Lucy Powell insisted she'd been misquoted, but Ed got on with it. He knows he has the trust of these voters. As he said today, it's the undecided he needs to convince, and he's got just a day left to do it.